so long, this is going to be a reset.
All right. She didn't even have to respond.
Yeah, but it goes right there.
I saw that, and I hesitated.
Written if you want a second. I think, though, that the appropriate, the good remark that has been already, that we should be singing happy birthday to Mr. O'Connell.
Oh, Archie Con. Thank you, Mr. President.
I'm planning that whole thing around, but that's, we don't have birthdays.
William Buckley and the other Americans inducted to Vietnam?
That's something I can't talk about because, but believe me, this is very much in our minds. We haven't forgotten that they're in captivity, but I don't think it'd be productive for us to talk about what we're doing.
Are you relieved to see there's a videotape showing that they're alive and well?
Yes, because if we can take it for granted that that is recent, we've never been able to establish that one way or the other. We've just had to assume that they are.
Can you say that your quiet efforts have made any progress, Mr. President, in securing their release?
I'm not going to tell the score.
5 states. Thank you.
He's interested in
it. I have this opportunity to thank all of you for what you did, particularly in those first 2 years, to help us get.
George?
Hello, Bill.
Simplifying of our tax structure, I mentioned in the inaugural remarks, and we'll speak of it again in the State of the Union address, but it is a priority issue, and I think it's a priority issue with the people, because I brought something in here. If you haven't seen it this morning in the Washington Post, that's the story that has appeared in the Post to the effect that a poll has been taken nationwide, and the people, 2-1, support the simplifying and reforming of the tax structure. And even those who knew nothing about this particular matter of the Treasury study that's been made still came up with the fact that even more than the amount of tax they paid, they resented more the complexity of it and handling the present tax structure. So if anyone needs any bolstering, that's what the people feel. Anyway, you're members of the tax writing committees, and we're counting on you for help when we come forward with a proposal. I know that the Treasury proposal has created something of a stir so far. It'll cause a lot of debate and actually thus help us fashion the proposal that we hope will be politically practical and that we'll be talking to you about. So far, the status is we have not roundtabled among ourselves that proposal other than taking a look at it, because all of the time so far we've spent around this table hammering out the budget that is going to be presented on the 4th. Then, from now on, we'll have time to get at the other at that, because we do want that to go forward, but we want them both on a separate track.
Mr. President, I have somebody said we need a mandatory, so I want to make sure that somebody out there takes our picture and says we have a mandatory.
Is there a mandatory?
I told the Alcalde last night that when, what's his name, the fellow from Minnesota said that I had a secret plan for paying off the deficit, I said, we do, for selling Minnesota.
Can we read district first?
Well, we've had a lot of, well, I'm glad you came down here. We've had a lot of legislative accomplishments in this first term, and the reason I think for our success has been our unity. We've worked together on even some of the most controversial issues. And you, the Republican Whip Organization, led by Trent Lott, I relied heavily on you during the first term, and you've been a consistent source of sound advice, hard work, and you deserve much of the credit for legislative victories. Every once in a while, I sneak up into the Channel 8 and I report and see some of you. But this is going to have to continue, this spirit of cooperation, if we're to meet the new challenges that are facing us. We have a unique opportunity to strengthen our economy, to reduce international tensions, and I am not willing to accept the conventional wisdom that we face a legislative stalemate in the House of Representatives. Tip has assured me we don't. But I am counting on you to keep the Republican House members together for the big battles that are going to be, that we're going to see this year. And we have a lot of tough issues like MX and Central America, the deficit reduction measures and tax reform. And we're going to have your help on all of those. Now, I should stop talking and ask George to say a few words.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Hello there. How do you do? Good to see you. Good morning. McFarland?
McFarland, sir.
Improving our relations, might we can take care of that.
Mm-hmm.
supposed to be here.
Hello. See you.
Mr. President, how are you, sir? It's good to see you again.
Nice to see you. Wonderful to see you, sir. Good to see you. Come in. Come in, I'll take that chair over there.
Okay.
I'll take the one on the right.
Oh, Penny, sorry.
All right, fine.
Excuse me, Bruce.
Kind of waiting for Craig.
Yes.
Small talk for a minute or two here.
The cold?
What?
Did you survive the cold last week?
Yes, although I've got a personal example of how cold it really was. There's those plants, whatever they are, they get a white flower, and they actually put them in a bigger pot, they grow bigger. There was one up in my study, so that it stood over this high, and the leaves are about twice that big when they get that big. And it's in front of the window that we open in my study, which is right near the door into the bedroom. So we open that at night to get a little fresh air in the house, even if it's cold. And on the day of the inaugural, I got air. Just the air coming in through that window.
Mr. President.
It's good to see you. Our gentleman here is very good.
How are you doing? How are you doing?
Minister, how are you, sir?
How are you?
Just finally delighted to see you. Bud.
That's Warren Dexter.
Good morning, sir. Nice to see you. Good to see you.
Glad to hear you.
Please come in.
Morning, Professor. There's you up there in the command.
You can see a few traces out there, a snowman out here in the Rose Garden.
So far, the movie.
It's been a strange winter. For a while, we weren't having any. It seemed to go along, and the grass was green, and everything was nice. Then we started getting winter, and then it would go away, and the snow would melt off, and just about the time we were pleased with that, you'd get another snowstorm.
We have a too good winter. We need the winter only to go in the winter. The rain is not all the day. When it's dry season, it means that when we show the water, they're all living.
Fine. These are our
painkillers.
We don't get a few footage.
Ours is not theirs.
That's part of it. It belongs to us. That'll bring you in.
Sit in front of the fire?
Good.
You've got pictures of me getting close to the fireplace ever since the inauguration, but
it's the same. We met the Libyans at the Security Council today. And have you been briefed on that plot to blow up the chain? Yeah, the whole cabinet.
Yes. Oh, what is it now? Hello there.
Not seeing you. We're going to talk.
What else? Where is that? Here we go.
The ambassador to Brazil.
See you. Yes.
Hello there. Ambassador to Lima.
Here, Admiral Warren Dexter.
Mr. President, nice to meet you.
Well, come in.
My name is Brazil.
Mr. President, are you considering something new to help the farmers? How do you think your budget will be received? How do you think your budget will be received?
No questions.
Sevilla rule in Brazil now?
Democratic.
Sevilla rule in Brazil?
I have to answer that for yes.
Vice, please. Thank you.